Hey guys, this is Rudy Banks. Welcome back to the channel, The Entrepreneur Journey. Today we're going to talk about Max Bounty. And I really want to stress the point of why you need to be tracking your links. If you're doing any type of advertising, you must track your links and avoid this mistake. I almost made a big one today. Stay tuned. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Man, I dodged a big one today. If you don't know about my channel, you know, I talk about the entrepreneur journey, going from corporate America to entrepreneurship, the freedom lifestyle. You know, I have an offline business. I do online marketing as well. And a lot of my channel, you know, a lot of you guys have come to this channel based on some of the marketing videos I've been putting out. So thank you for subscribing. Today, I just want to share something with you to help you avoid this mistake. It could have been very costly, but I lucked out. Unfortunately, I was primed and ready to make some big money at the end of this campaign that I was doing with Max Bounty, and I'll just show you what happened. So, as you know, I use Click Magic. I use that tool to track my clicks. So I'm doing Bing ads, and just to show you, the campaign I was running was Everyday Moms. So essentially it was a campaign to provide samples, you know, to moms, and basically people were searching for free diapers and things like that. I had different ads, different campaigns set up, and basically people were searching for using my keywords. I had my keywords all set up. This is from yesterday, actually. Today's the 26th, and I dialed down my click rates and stuff, and just to try to optimize my campaign and just improve my ROI, my return on investment, and I was getting pretty good results. So if I scroll fast forward to today, I'm like, man, I'm getting clicks, but when I go back to my tracker for today, the 26th, where we at? I was only getting I got 24 clicks, and when I go to Max Bounty, I wasn't receiving any conversion, like any conversions or any clicks on the site. It was nothing registering. I was like, man, that's awful crazy. So, you know, when I originally started out, I was just doing a basic landing page, and I'm going to show you that. Guys, I'm pretty transparent on what I do, so I don't have anything to hide, but this is basically a landing page I was using. So I had a YouTube video, and basically they would click this link and it would take them to the Max Bounty offer. And it was basically this offer here. And every time I had a referral, I got $2.25. So I had this thing, man, I had it really set up. Basically I would receive emails from Max Bounty that I got a conversion. I had this little coin thing planned. So I set up a filter on my email. Basically every time I received a sale, I would actually get a, you know, like a coin, like money dropping in the piggy bank per se. And it was all driven off of, you know, my email and using Click Magic. So anytime I got a sale, Click Magic would send me email. And I showed you that in another video. Just click up here somewhere, you'll see it. And I'll show you how to get daily emails knowing that you're getting paid. So I like automation, if you don't know me by now. But anyway, so I'm just monitoring. I'm like, man, I'm not getting any sales. I'm not hearing those dings today. Something's wrong. What's going on? Now, at the time, all I had was, I just had this button just going directly to the Max Bounty offer. Now, if you look in the lower right, the left corner, you see it's actually a my Click Magic link. I just changed that today because I was like, something's not right. So what I ended up doing, which I probably should have done originally, if you go right here, I added a button tracker. So basically this link populates, not to get too technical on you guys, but essentially, when you go to a website, you want to monitor that click. And so if they're coming from an ad, I can monitor which link they clicked and which ad they ran, what they were on when they, or which keyword they typed in, all that good stuff right from ClickMagic. And so I populate that click ID. So when the person purchases from Max Bounty, that click is registered back to ClickMagic, and then I know exactly that this click led to that sale. You might have heard of things like sales pixels and stuff like that in Facebook pixels or Google pixels and stuff like that. Kind of the same concept, similar. But so I was noticing that I was getting a lot of clicks, but I wasn't getting any conversions. And then I was like, okay, well, I know my click-through rate, once they hit my landing page, I know there's like 60% chance for them clicking that button to go to the offer. So I was like, okay, I'll wait a little bit. But then I noticed that I wasn't getting any clicks on Max Bounty. And I said, let me make sure things are running properly. So originally I would have this button right here, like the free diapers button or free diapers link. And that's the short link that goes into my ad. So if you have Facebook or whatever, I use Bing. So anytime somebody click my ad, they're essentially clicking this link here, and then I would monitor, total clicks, and it would tell me the unique clicks and if there's any false flagged or fake clicks. And today I was like, man, I'm getting a lot of clicks, but I didn't see any sales over here. And I was like, what the heck is going on? So I was like, well, let me go ahead and bite the bullet and go ahead and do this thing the right way. Because I had been slacking. I was been making money. So I was like, I know it's working. But I didn't know how much, Max Bounty was shaving versus just, do I need to improve my landing page? But I was making money, so I just let it go. And I figured I would do improvements along the way. So what I did, I changed this button. Instead of going directly to the Max Bounty offer, I changed it to a short link and click magic, and that way I could track that, okay, the person came to the site, I'm registering the click ID. So this is, make sure you can see this. So essentially I'm setting a variable here. This is all done behind the scenes, but that number right there, every time a person comes to a site, that click ID is some hidden number or variable that you can pull out. So you know that they clicked your ad, you can track that all the way from clicking your ad to when they make a sale at Max Bounty, because it's going to post back to ClickMagic and let you know that you had a full circle sale. All right, stay with me. And so, like I said, I wasn't seeing any sales. I'm like, that's not right. So what I did, I ended up changing my button link from the direct link, and I put a ClickMagic tracking link, and it clearly shows that I had 14 clicks, and there was, I guess, identified three as unique. So something's going on fishy. Something's fishy right there. There's a lot of, that's not my IP address. So something was, and this is these are all mobile. So something was definitely not working right. And long story short, I started checking my email because I was just about to email my affiliate manager. And I go through my emails, I'm looking for Max Bounty, and I saw that I got paid on a few things. Well, then I just did a filter because I saw Max Bounty support campaign cancellation notice. So guys, make sure you check, if you're in Max Bounty, make sure you check your emails, make sure you're filtering based on this type of status, because what happened was the particular campaign I was running, which was called Everyday Moms, if you go to click on this now, bam, gone. So what happened, luckily for me, yesterday, I made some sales yesterday, but as of 7 p.m. Eastern time, they cut it off. So anything I ran today, which is the 26th, again, that was yesterday at 7 p.m., I didn't get credit for. Now, I got lucky because today I've only spent $2.50. So I really got lucky, guys. So today, guys, I wanted to put this video together for you really quick because I can't stress enough the importance of tracking and metrics. If you're going to be in this business, I mean, if you want to continue to do free stuff, put in a Bitly tracker or something. But if you're going to do paid ads, it's very important that you put your time and effort and put some money into some software, whether it's ClickMagic or ClickMeter, whatever it may be. There's some other tools out there too, but I use ClickMagic. I've done a couple videos on it, so if you can learn more about it below. But make sure you do that, because now you have the insight. You're connected, you got insight. Once you know there's a problem, you can easily address it. But if you don't know there's a problem, you're gonna waste a lot of money, you're gonna waste a lot of time. The lesson learned from this is make sure you're monitoring your email, put some flags on. If you're saying anything about cancellation, make sure there's an escalation process, whether it's you can take the email, maybe do some type of SMS message, or I don't know, shoot off some fireworks or whatever, make your phone explode, whatever it's got to do. But make sure you stop that campaign before you waste money on ads if you're paying for ads. And guys, I hope this content is value to you. I'll continue to do my best and share more content. Make sure you like, share, subscribe, comment below if this was helpful, and if you want another type of video, if you want another video related to CPA and affiliate marketing, please comment below. Or if you want something on music or technology, I can do that too. So guys, I'll see you in another video. Peace.